Welcome to all 7th standard students to our subject social science. Today we will discuss about our lesson number 9, because for your second unit test our social science first, second, third and 9th chapter will be there for the examination. 9th chapter is a continuation of our third chapter. In third chapter we have already learned that one related to our government, three levels of a government. In local level government is there, state level government is there, and the central government or the union government is there. So in this 9th chapter we will learn about administration of the state government. So let's start our 9th chapter. Administration of the state. We have already learned that the administration of our country functions at three levels: local level, state level, and central level. In the previous year, we have learned about the working of local self-government institutions. In this chapter, we shall learn about how the administration functions at the state level in a democracy. What are the functions of the state government? What are the roles of ministers and members of the legislative assembly? How do people put forward their questions and ideas to the government? How do they ask for the fulfillment of their demands? So in last year, in 6th standard, we have already learned that our local self-government, the functions, what are the duties and functions of the local self-government, how the members, the local self-government members are elected, that process that we have already learned. So how the local self-government is helping the people, that we have already learned there in the last year, 6th standard. So in this 7th standard we will learn about the state government administration, how we the people elect the government, what is the importance of people, or what is the functions of the state government. So these all the matters we will learn in this chapter. So take page number 46. Page number 46. You might have observed leaders of your area presenting health issues to the local health officials. The district collector or other officials. But have you seen the member of legislative assembly of your area? Have you heard about the legislative assembly? So member of legislative assembly, MLA. In our area, in our Amreli, a constituency is there. So we have our own MLA. Who is our MLA? Our MLA's name is Shri Paresh Bhai Dhanani. And the legislative assembly members are known as MLA or member of legislative assembly. So who is an MLA? A definition is given there. The legislative assembly members are known as MLA or member of legislative assembly. It's a full form. MLAs are directly elected by the people. After being elected from their constituency, they become the MLAs and form the government. Thus, we can conclude that MLAs are the representatives of the people. So, a different constituency is there, and in each constituency, we, the people, will select our MLAs. the people will select their MLAs through the voting system. In last year, we have already learned that one. In every 5 years, elections are there. And a person, he is an Indian citizen. He must be an Indian citizen. And he have the election voter ID card. And completing the 18 years old, then he can cast his vote. So through the election, we can select the MLAs. And the MLA is selected by the people. Direct election done for that one. So the MLAs are elected by the people. So they are the representatives of the people. MLAs are the representatives of the people because we selected them. That is why. All the states of India have a legislative assembly. That is an important point. Just underline that one. All the states of India have a legislative assembly is there. Then what is the legislative assembly? Each state is divided into different constituencies. From each constituency, one representative is elected by the people. The number of seats in the legislative assembly differs from state to state and is decided on the basis of population. So each and every state will be divided into different constituency. Different constituencies are there, each and every states. And that is different on the basis of the population. That is different. Basis of the population. Constituencies are different. So, on that constituency difference, that is, so constituency that is different on the basis of population. In Gujarat, 182 constituencies are there, but in Goa, the constituency's number is very less because of the population. If we compare Gujarat and Goa, then Gujarat have more population. So definitely constituency numbers are very high there in Gujarat. The elections are held every 5 years. The candidate can either represent a particular party or stand for election as an independent candidate. Thus, the MLAs can belong to different parties. So, in every 5 years, the election will be held. And the MLAs, those who want to participate there in the election, or for the MLAs, they can stand independently they can stand, or they can stand by on any political party's name. That option is there. The Legislative Assembly of Gujarat has 182 seats and is situated in Gandhinagar, which is the capital of Gujarat. So the capital of Gujarat, that is Gandhinagar, you already know that one. The Legislative Assembly of Gujarat, our Gujarat Legislative Assembly, that is there in our capital city, Gandhinagar. Just underline that one. The Legislative Assembly meets in the Vitthalbhai Patel Vidhan Sabha Gram. That also just underline. Then a picture of our Legislative Assembly. Gujarat, a picture is given there. That is our Legislative Assembly of Gujarat. Now the next page number 47. Let us learn about how a minister or the chief minister is selected from among the MLAs. We have already learned that one. In all over Gujarat, 182 seats are there. 182 constituencies are there. Now I will not going to explain any political party's name or something. So just take one example. Political party A and political party B. So in election, total 182 seats are there. 182 constituencies are there. You can just imagine that one. In political party A,
they won 100 seats and political party B got 82 seats. So which party have the majority? You can say that one political party A, because they got 100 seats. So definitely the governor, the constitutional head of the state, governor will call the majority party to form the government. They have the rights to form the government. The leader of the majority party, political party A, he will be the chief minister. And under his guidelines, he can make the group of ministers. The party which has the largest number of MLAs or gains a majority with the support of other parties and or independent candidates forms the government. So which party is having the majority, that particular party can the right to form the government, the state government. The governor appoints the leader of the majority party as the chief minister. Then yesterday we have already learned that one. The constitutional head of the state, which means governor, he appoints the majority party leader as a chief minister of the state. He or she is invited to form the council of ministers. Then he have the rights, the chief minister have the rights to form the council of ministers for different departments. He can call 20-25 members, MLAs, to form the ministry, council of ministers. And in each and every ministers, he can give the duties there. He will be there for the education department. He will be there for the finance department, like different departments, he will allow to be there. The party that forms the government is known as the ruling party, while the other party form the opposition. Just to underline that one. So which party have the majority and that party will form the government, that party is known as a ruling party. And the other party, that means they got 82 seats, they will be there in the opposition party. So this is the formation. In this way, we form the formation of a chief minister and a council of ministers. After elections, the governor appoints the chief minister and the council of ministers, who will be collectively responsible for the administration of the state and the functioning of the various ministries. After election, the governor will give the authority or the authorization to guide the state, and for that chief minister is there and council of ministers are there. They have a collective responsibility is there for the state. Each ministry is housed in different office premises. The Legislative Assembly is the place where all the MLAs belonging to both the ruling party and the opposition assembled for the discussions. Many MLAs have a dual responsibility as an MLA and as a minister. So Legislative Assembly, the first one, legislature, yesterday we have learned that one, the organs of the government, first one is a legislature. So in legislature or the Legislative Assembly, all the MLAs, not only the ruling party MLAs, all the MLAs in Gujarat, 182 MLAs are there. So the 182 MLAs will sit together and make decisions on the state matters. So in Legislative Assembly, we can see all the MLAs, all MLAs. There is no any differences there. Only ruling party MLAs are here. There is no any that type of any partiality or something is not there. All the MLAs can attend there in the Legislative Assembly meetings based on for the Gujarat related matters. This is related to legislative assembly, legislator. Now the second organ of the government, that is executive. Who all are there in executive, that we can see. The other organ of the state government is the executive. The second organ of the state government, that is executive, which comprises of the governor, the chief minister and the council of ministers. Just to underline that one. In executive, who all are there? Chief minister is there, council of minister is there, governor is there. These three are the main important there in the executive section. The administrative officials who work under the guidance and control of the ministers are also a part of the executive body. So those who are working under different ministers department or the chief ministers department, whatever it is there, they all are a part of executive. The council of ministers are called government executives, while the administrative officials are known as administrative executives. So we can make them divide as the ministers, the council of ministers, they known as executive, government executives. The council of ministers, they known as government executives, while the administrative officials are known as administrative executive. They have the duty of administration section, so we can call them administrative executive. So this is the main important things in the 9th chapter. Now three sections are remaining there: governor, chief minister and the legislative assembly. A detailed note is there that we can take there in the next class. So this 9th chapter, read once again. Simple matters are mentioned there because already it's a chapter introduction we have completed there in the 3rd chapter. So simple matters are mentioned there in the 9th chapter. Just read once again this chapter and understand the things properly.